To learn any language, you need three: dedication, passion, and perseverance. These three words, DPP, because these three words will take you to the end of that and make you to learn that language. In this blog, I'm going to give you three easy steps to learn the language English. Difficult thing in learning a language is when you start facing the difficulty of not understanding a point, and then you start getting demoralized and say, not for me, or I'm not able to learn a language, or any kind of thing. But the difficult thing for you is to understand that you have to be consistent enough, you have to be dedicated. You have to have a passion for learning that particular language. You will have to have a perseverance of learning that repeatedly. And you also have to maintain a consistency. That consistency will let you to reach to the target. Consistency is your target. Passion is your learning for that. Dedication is your effort that you are putting. And perseverance is basically combining all these three factors. To learn the language English, there are two ways. One is a written English, one is a spoken English. In written English, you will have to work on grammar, punctuation, this and that, everything. Basically, it's a little more tough than learning the spoken English, because spoken English is basically a formation of words in the form of a sequence, and then that sequence completes a statement. One example, three letter or three words combining forms a sentence. Whenever you meet somebody, you ask, how are you? How are you? That's a three letter word, but it forms a sentence. This three letter word, if you say you are how, does not make any sense. Are you how? Does not make any sense. How you are, somewhat makes sentence, but still incorrect, improper. Now, this is basically the way to make it understand that the sequencing of word is very important in spoken English. Now, the three ways how you can build this sequence, or how you can build this language learning, is: number one, read newspaper, and especially English newspaper. Does not matter which section of the newspaper or the whole newspaper you are reading, whichever part matters you the most, read that. In English newspaper, there is a story which comes, there is a column which comes, there is an article which comes. The idea for you is to just read that newspaper, just to create that bag of words in your mind, because that forms the full sentence. As you read, you get lot and lot of vocabularies in your brain, lot and lot of words in your brain, it is going up, and then the bag of words is getting created. Then transform yourself. For example, when you are meeting next time to somebody, or when you are trying to meet people, rather than talking in any other language, try to communicate with them in English. If they ask some English, don't hesitate. Whether you are speaking correct or incorrect, you start speaking up. You might lag at the beginning, but eventually you will reach to that fluidly flow of speaking up the things, and that will take you to the next level. Second, watch series, watch music, watch this with English subtitle, watch English news on YouTube, or any content that you're watching on digital platform, watch with English subtitle. The reason is because English will let you understand that. For example, when you want to learn some other language, you watch that language movie with English subtitle just to understand what they're speaking in that language. Now, that after learning that word, you convert that into the second word. The same way, you will have to learn and listen to English with English subtitle just to catch the lip sync. What they are speaking versus what the word is visible, that is basically, it will be a lip sync. Then what? Then you try to read those things while they are speaking. So you are hearing as well as you are reading. So your eyes are recording the words, your ears are recording the sound. So both will become a combination of pack. And when you start speaking, it will become in the same lip syncing way it will come. You are speaking and the words are flowing from your brain. And the third thing, practice, practice, practice. Now here, practice means not writing practice or anything. Practice means speaking out. Practice means reading out, voicing out what you learn, what you read, how you read. Connect the dots. Understand where the dots are connecting, how the sentence formation is working and all. Just work, visualize in your brain. Well, that's all for now in this blog. I just wanted to make it very simple, very small, but at the same time very informative by giving a lot of graphics. Be sure to like the channel video, comment down below and subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. If at all you have subscribed and you have pressed the bell icon, please like the video because your like gives me motivation of doing more videos for you. And comment down below what you find interesting, what you want to learn more. If at all anything I have to explain, I'll explain. At the same time, make sure you share the video with your friends and family and others who are in need of it, who face difficulty or challenges in learning the language. Stay tuned, keep watching your own channel Siddharth World and keep enjoying the videos. This is Siddharth signing off for now. Until the next.